You want to see a bunch of grown adults crying at a preschool show? Well, you should check out the new episode of Bluey, The Sign. I mean, I didn't cry because I'm a big, strong man. But I have to admit, Bluey really has its feelers out. Really tickling us millennial parents. I mean, for a generation raised by mostly dysfunctional parents. If you show them a bunch of stable, married couples and responsible fathers and that type of stuff, we're sure to get emotional about it.
Someone didn't love you enough when you were little, did they?
But we're not going to talk about all that. We're going to leave our traumas at the door. Because today we're going to talk about the philosophical undertones of the latest episode of Bluey the Sign. So if you haven't seen that episode, this is your chance to get the hell out of here. You can leave. 3, 2, 1, let's go. The philosophical setup that like undergirds this whole episode begins with a story told by Calypso, Bluey's preschool teacher. In the story, an old man has a prized horse. But one day, inexplicably, the old man's horse runs away. And people come to him and say, oh, what bad luck. And the old man responds with, we'll see. Sure enough, one day the horse returns, but he returns with a bunch of wild stallions, increasing his number of horses. And the people come to the old man and say, oh, what good luck. And he says, we'll see. One day, the old man's son is riding one of the horses and breaks his leg. And people come to the old man and say, oh, what bad luck. And the old man responds with, oh, we'll see. Then, a war breaks out, and the military is conscripting fighting-aged men. But the old man's son has a broken leg and can't go into service. The war goes horribly wrong, and many die. And clearly, the old man's son's broken leg has saved his life. The whole point of the story, right, is that good luck begets bad luck, and bad luck begets good luck. And this isn't a novel concept. This is an ancient one. And in fact, the story itself is identical to what you would see in an ancient Chinese philosophy. Specifically, this story is ripped from a collection of texts called the Huai Nanzi. It's a 2nd century BC philosophical collection. The philosophy is varied in this book, but for the most part, it seems to be pulling from Taoist philosophies. And I'll give you a bit of an example here. Reading from the Tao Te Ching, when people see things as beautiful, other things become ugly. When people see some things as good, other things become bad. Therefore the master acts without doing and teaches without saying. Things arise and she lets them come. Things disappear and she lets them go. Taoist philosophy is sort of riddled with this duality, the good and the bad, the female and the male, the light and the dark. They all exist and coexist simultaneously. That's where this idea of yin and yang come from. But the central point that Bluey's teacher Calypso wants Bluey to get is that everything will work out the way it's supposed to. That's what she specifically tells Bluey. Everything will work out the way it's supposed to. And throughout the episode, Bluey has to sort of battle these things, to just let things be. You can argue that throughout the episode, Bluey is practicing Taoist philosophies. She is practicing action through non-action. In the episode The Sign, Bluey is upset that her parents are moving, and she desperately wants to stop them. Her desire to stop them from moving leads her to, in vain, try to remove the for sale sign from the front of the house with force. But of course, this isn't action through non-action, and she fails, and she's upset, and she's miserable about it. As the course of the episode goes on, Bluey learns to be content with the way things are going. There's a cyclical nature to the whole episode that I won't get into that mirrors the story of the old man. Good things happen, followed by bad things. Bad things happen, followed by good things. And in the end, when Bluey learns to accept that, things work out the way they're supposed to. The family doesn't move. But that's really not the point, right? That if Bluey moved, that would be the way that it's supposed to be. That Bluey should be content with that scenario. And that good things could possibly come from that bad thing. Things will work out the way it's supposed to be. Not to advocate for any religion or philosophy. That's not the point of my channel. But I do think finding the silver lining in bad situations is a great moral lesson, not just for children, but a great moral lesson for all of us. To see that silver lining. Let me know what you thought about the new episode of Bluey in the comments below. And let me know what you think about how it relates to Chinese philosophy, I guess. This is a totally unscripted episode, and I just see how it went. If you liked it, leave a comment, leave a like, and I will see you next time.